Morning students, how are you all? I hope all of you are doing well. A hearty welcome to today's English class. Today we shall learn the unit 7 from the workbook. Students, please take page number 101. See the following table. Words in the first column occur in the lesson Packing from Beehive. In pairs, look up the meaning of the words in each row in a dictionary. Write in your notebook how they differ in meaning from one another. So, these words in the first column, boots, edge, chair, hamper, they are from the lesson Packing. But similar words with a slight meaning difference is which belongs to the same category are given here. For example, boots, shoes, slippers, clogs, moccasins, flip-flops. So all are different types of chappals. So you just look into the dictionary and find out the difference of meanings. Same way, edge, border, boundary, demarcation, cutoff, point, brink. Chair, armchair, reclining chair, wheelchair, ergonomic chair, rocking chair. So this is for your homework. You find, look into the dictionary and find out and write down the meanings. Either in your notebook or if there is place, you adjust in the workbook itself. For the interactive section, I will be asking you the answers. Next one, read the beautiful description by Karishma Kripalani given below. Then work in pairs, underline the adjectives and list them. You can use this while writing the travelogue or planning a trip to a place of your choice. So, this one, it is a passage given and we have to read it and find out the adjectives. You already learned about adjectives. What is an adjective? It is a word that describes a noun or a pronoun. Or you can say that a word that modifies the meaning of a noun or a pronoun. So it is very easy to find out. You have already learned in the smaller classes. Let us go through it. Varkala. Imagine looking down on the vast expanse of the sea with its mighty waves, cresting and crushing the sun, then claiming it with the soft hush of their froth and foam from the effort. So it is describing the Varkala, the beautiful place, beautiful description of the Varkala. So here in the first sentence, vast expanse. Vast is an adjective. Also mighty waves. Mighty is an adjective. You have to write in the column that is given below the passage. A soft breeze blows in, the sun shimmers in the distant waters. The dolphins glisten as they leap up now and then. It is a kilometer long walk on these rugged rocks that hurtle down to the beach. So rugged rocks, rugged is an adjective. You see sunbathers, happy families, lifeguards, the usual buzz of a vacation. But up here you are a silent witness as a stone rattles off into the wind. This is Varkala, one of the many beaches along Kerala's 600 km shoreline, but perhaps the best there is. Kannur has the cliffs but no sand. The Cherai beach has a coconut grove but no cliff. Kovalam has too many tourists but neither the cliffs nor the estuaries. Varkala, just 41 km north of Thiruvananthapuram, has everything, never-ending cliffs. So never-ending is an adjective. White sand, white is an adjective. bubbling mineral springs. Bubbling is an adjective. Quaint coves. Coves are bays, B-A-Y-S, bays. Quaint means attractive. So quaint also is an adjective. Swaying palms. Swaying is an adjective. Glimpses of history. Wonders of geography. And spiritual richness. Spiritual is an adjective. And rejuvenation therapies. Varkala is the only place in southern Kerala where one can find cliffs adjacent to the Arabian Sea. They are known among geologists as the Varkala Formation. There are numerous water spouts and geysers on the cliff faces, making this place a natural spa. Spa is a location where mineral rich spring water is used to give medicinal baths. So this water of this spring contains minerals. They are rich in minerals. So this water is used for a medical treatment. It has got a medicinal effects. So that is why it is called a natural spa. Means by itself it is rich in minerals which can be used as a medicinal water. So the adjectives are vast, mighty, rugged, never ending, white, bubbling, quaint, swaying, spiritual. Now in the given space, write the adjectives that you want or like or wish, prefer to do, or you don't want, like, wish or prefer to do. On Sundays, I like to play and watch TV. To play and watch TV. On Sundays, I don't like to read anything except stories. I don't like to read anything except stories. In the evenings, I want to see a picture on a TV and talk with friends. In the evenings, I want to see a picture on TV and talk with friends. In the evenings, I don't want to play. In the evenings, I don't want to play. In the playground, I want to run. Or I like to run. In the playground, I don't want to relax and sit. I don't want to relax and sit. When I go to the fair, I want to visit all the stalls. I want to visit all the stalls. STALLS. In the fair, I don't want to go to overcrowded places. I don't want to go to overcrowded or overcrowded places. In the chapter packing of your textbook, Beehive, you have read about simple commands. Directions to reach your home, use of do's and don'ts, and instructions for making something, for example, tea, coffee, etc. Read the following sentences. Against each sentence, write a simple command, direction, do's, don'ts, instruction in the space provided. Sit here and help your brother in learning mathematics. Sit here. Can make a simple command, sit here. Another sentence can be made, help your brother in learning mathematics. Help your brother in learning mathematics. Ride a bicycle and go near the river. You will see your friend swimming in the river. Ride a bicycle. Go near the river. Ride a bicycle, full stop. Go near the river. See your friend swimming. See your friend swimming. Get up and go. You cannot waste time sleeping. Get up and go. Full stop. Don't waste time sleeping. Don't waste time sleeping. Do not wake anyone up suddenly while he or she is sleeping. Don't wake anyone up suddenly while they are sleeping. Don't wake anyone up suddenly while they are sleeping. In summer, keep a large bowl of water outside for birds and animals to drink water from. Keep a large bowl of water outside for birds and animals in summer. Keep a large bowl of water outside for birds and animals in a summer. Read the passage given below. There are language errors, for example, the use of tenses. Correct this and rewrite the passage in the space provided. Gwalior, the jewel of Madhya Pradesh. Gwalior is a curious mixture of old and new. Sprawling city in the northernmost part of Madhya Pradesh. Here, this is not necessary. You can cut off this. It offers a feast of a historic sites, museums, parks, shops, cultural programs, and cuisines. So, it offers. The northernmost city, Gwalior, was established in the 8th century AD and named after Saint Gwalipa. The city was dominated by its hilltop fort, a symbol of Rajput valor and chivalry. The 15th century palace of Raja Man Singh is located in the citadel. The fort also houses HOUSES Telika Mandir, an ancient temple. Citadel is a fortress, typically one on high ground. Gajri Mahal at the foot of the fort, Fort is one of the first museums of sculpture in the country. Gwalior has also the distinction of being a center of Indian classical music. Mia Tansen, one of the 9 jewels of the court of Emperor Akbar the Great, is buried at Gwalior. Every year in December, a great music festival is held here to commemorate this great singer. Rewrite, you have to write down this passage correctly in the space given in the workbook. Rearrange each set of words to make sentences. Use appropriate punctuation marks. The orphan child, the court guardian of appointed him. The court appointed him guardian of the orphan child. Friends, time, enemies, the worst, mates. Time makes friends the worst enemies. Of the club, elected secretary him there. They elected him secretary of the club. We saw the approaching storm. So students, with this we come to the end of the unit 7. Thank you students. Have a nice day.